In this video, you'll learn how to properly set up moving platforms so that they work correctly with kinematic physics, are as smooth as possible, and it's easy for us to customize where they move to. Howdy, and welcome to Game Endeavor. If you're anything like me, then you've probably spent countless hours struggling to make moving platforms work properly in Godot. Well, thanks to a few tweaks available in the new 3.1 update, we're now able to create flawless moving platforms. Let's go ahead and get started. For this project, I already have a scene prepared for the moving platform. It has a Node 2D as the root, a Kinematic Body 2D for the platform, and a tween which we'll be using for the motion. The root node has a script where we'll be writing most of our code. It's important that the actual platform is a Kinematic Body 2D. Much of the magic behind moving platforms is automatically done for us when the platform is a kinematic body. If you use a static body, then the platform will slide out from under the player, and that's not much use to any of us. Despite being kinematic bodies, we're actually not allowed to use either the move and slide or move and collide methods, so we're going to need to manipulate their positions directly. This means that collision detection will not be enabled when we move the platforms, so you will need to be mindful of where you place them and may need to include some logic to crush the player if they get caught under a platform. There are countless ways to adjust the position of a platform. You can use an animation player, manual position adjustments, or path followers. For this tutorial, though, we will be using a tween node. We want the platform to move back and forth continuously, so we need to make sure that the loop property is enabled for the tween. And since we're using this to move the platform, we're going to switch its playback process mode over to physics. The main reason I recommend using a tween to animate moving platforms is because they're easy to set up and it's simple for us to customize. With this method, we'll be able to tell the platform to move to a specific point in any direction. Inside of the script for our moving platform, I have already cached a couple of nodes for convenience. We will still need a few variables, however, so let's go ahead and define those right quick. We want the platforms to move to a location and then briefly stop to rest for a moment once they reach that location. We will define this time as a constant named idle duration, and I will set mine to 1.0 seconds. We also want to be able to define where the platform moves when we're placing it in our level. So we'll define an exported variable named moveTo, and we'll declare it as a vector2. The value isn't important, feel free to set it to whatever is convenient for you. I will be setting mine equivalent to 2 tile widths to the right. We also want the platform to move at a consistent speed regardless of the distance it has to move. So we're going to define a float variable named speed. This will be the number of tiles that the platform will move per second. And I will default mine to 3.0. As soon as our platform is loaded and ready, we want to go ahead and set up our tween, so we'll create a method named initTween and call it in our ready method. In this method, we're going to set it up so that the platform starts idling, moves to the specified position, idles again, then returns to its initial position, and then repeat this process. Before we get started doing that, we first need to know how long it will take the platform to move to the specified location, which we'll do by declaring a variable named duration and setting it equal to the length of our moveTo vector, divided by speed times our tile size, which I have mine defined as globals.unitSize. To ensure that there are no rounding errors, we need to cast the divisor as a float. Now we can set up our tween. We'll call its interpolate property method, give it our platform as the node, and position as the property to interpolate. With this platform, you'll recall that I parented it to a node 2D. Because of this, we can assume that the platform will start with a local position of 0, 0. So we'll set the initial value as vector2.0, the final value as our moveTo variable, then give it duration as the duration parameter. With moving platforms, we can only use a linear transition. This is because as we adjust the distance that our platform moves, any other transition would cause the motion of the platform to be wildly inconsistent, generally causing short distances to be quick and snappy, while long distances feel a little more sluggish. So we'll set the transition parameter as tween.translinear. And since we're using a linear transition, the easing doesn't matter, so set it to whatever you like. This method has a final optional parameter which we'll be making use of. You'll recall that we want the platform to start in an idled state, so we will pass in the idle duration constant as the delay parameter. This will get our platform moving to where we want it, but we also want it to come back when it's done. For that, we're going to need to call another interpolate property method, giving it platform and position again. But this time we're going to swap the initial and final values, which will cause it to return. And again, give it duration, tween.translinear, and whatever easing. But to make sure that the interpolation starts at the proper time, we will need to offset the delay parameter even more. We want it to wait until the first interpolation has finished, and then do the second delay. So we'll set the delay parameter to duration plus idle duration times 2. Finally, we can call the tween start method, and we have a platform that moves back and forth. However, if you're like me, then you're probably not too keen on having to use linear interpolation to move platforms. It's too sudden and doesn't look polished, but with a bit of ingenuity, we can try to get around this issue. Rather than moving the platform directly, we're going to tell the platform to start easing towards that position. So we'll define a class variable named follow and initialize it to be vector2.0. And in our initTween method, we'll change the parameters platform and position to self and follow. Then we'll create a physicsProcess method, and inside of it we'll set platform.position equal to platform.position linearly interpolated to our new follow vector and give it a weight. This will dictate how much smoothing is applied. I will use 0.075. And with that, we've finished the moving logic for our platform. Now we come to the part where in the past, moving platforms were a bit of a pain to deal with. If you stand on the platform as it moves horizontally, then you will notice that a bit of sliding occurs for the player. The main issue, however, comes when you stand on a vertical moving platform. It gets a lot more wonky, the player jitters on the platform, and will even become ungrounded, which will actually make jumps unresponsive if you're using the isOnFloor method to check for isGrounded. This is where the tweaks in 3.1 come in to help us fix moving platforms. First, to fix the sliding and other out-of-sync behaviors, Kinematic Body 2Ds now have a sync to physics property that you can set in the inspector. This is an absolute must for moving platforms and will completely fix our horizontal woes. Almost, but more on that later. Vertically, however, we still have an issue. Specifically, we still have jittering when the platform moves upward. To fix this, we will need to enable snapping for our player. This allows us to snap to the ground and will also fix the issue where the player overshoots slopes, which we manually had to fix in our platform player controller video. To use this, we need to change our move and slide method in our player controller to move and slide with snap. We will also need to tell the method when what direction and how far to check for snapping. So we'll declare a variable named snap and set it equal to vector2.down times 32 and pass it to the method. However, this will keep us constantly snapped to the ground, which isn't ideal in instances where we would like to jump. If you've been following along with the platformer series, then we already have a variable named isJumping that we set to be true when we jump, and we set it to be false when we're falling. We don't want to snap to the ground when we're jumping, so if we return to our snap property and add to it, if not jumping, else vector2.0, then we will stop snapping when we jump, and now we can snap perfectly to the platform and consistently move with it. If you're still having issues with moving platforms, however, then check to see if you have stopping on slopes enabled. For some reason, this seems to cause the platforms to stop working. As of creating this video, the stop on slopes parameter doesn't seem to have any effect. So you can just disable it and create your own stopping effect by setting your velocity.x to 0 if the player isn't pressing any move keys and if velocity is below a certain threshold. If you're watching this from the future and stop on slopes is fixed but still doesn't work properly with moving platforms, then an alternative solution would be to disable stop sloping if your horizontal floor velocity does not equal 0. If you want to continue learning about game development, then watch this video here. And if you're new, then join the sub club to get notified for future videos. And until next time, y'all take it easy.